morning, students. This is the second video of Knowing Our Past Classes. I have already discussed the topics of what is history, why do we need to study the history, and what are the classification of history. One question I ask you today. Do you know how historian arrange the events? Yes, they do it in the chronological order. What do you mean the chronological order? The chronological order means arranged in the order in which the events happened. The history we find the dates with BC and AD. BC means before the Christ and AD means Anno Domini, the year of the Lord. The AD usually written before the number. For example, AD 150, which means 150 years after the birth of Christ. Recent time, we usually do not AD before the year. That date before BC go backward. Thus, 232 will come before 185 BC. I hope you students, do you understand the difference between the BC and AD? BC go backward, AD go forward. BC means before the Christ, AD means after the Christ. Now we discuss the source material. Historians are more like a dictatives. They have a conclusions from clues and evidences which are available in the source material, which are two types. First one is archaeological sources, second one is literary sources. Archaeological sources, the study of the past based on the object. For example, toys, weapons, coins, jewelry, tools, poetry, etc. And for example of archaeological sources, inscriptions and monuments. Inscription means something is engraved in a hard surface like rocks, pillars, coins and etc. Monuments means palaces, temple and forts. And next one, literary sources. The literary sources further divided into two types. Religious sources and secular sources. In religious sources means the source is belonging to particular religion. For example, Vedas, Pitakas and Angas. And secular sources, the source is not belonging to any religion. For example, Kautilya's Arthashastra and Kalidasa Abhigana Shakuntalam. I hope you students, you all understand the topic. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.